Hi guys, so I just got back from the gym. The time right now is currently 6:45 p.m. right now in Arizona. And it's a very good thing that it's still early because the night is still young. And then also, I am planning to go out tonight with some of my friends. So, in this vlog, I'm going to be talking about a little bit of my fitness goals of how they've been like throughout, you know, January for the new year. And honestly, I have a lot of good things to say about it, and I'm very proud of myself because I've been very consistent with it. The second thing I'm gonna do is also get ready in terms of like doing my hair, putting on some makeup, dressing up pretty to go out tonight and just, you know, have a good time. Now, just as a heads up, I am no professional in styling hair and doing my makeup, especially the makeup part, but every time I do those things on myself to look good and presentable for any event, I like it and I think I look very pretty. So I am excited to share that with you guys tonight because it's gonna be a fun time. And you know, if you're a girly girl or if you're just any girl who loves to go out and get ready, you know that getting ready is the most funnest part. So let's get started. Okay, so a little bit of reflection as to what my workout looked like today. It was a focus of glutes and back, and some consistency that I have been putting in is definitely working on the lower body, because us girlies know, you know, that's the part that we kind of want to see grow more than the other parts of our body. But anyways, I am very proud to say that for 4 weeks straight, I was able to keep the consistency of working out 3 times a week. Even though my goal is to one day do 5 times a week, for now, it's a good start. I know I've told you guys before in previous vlogs that I've always wanted to create that consistency of working out again. And the fact that I was able, you know, to take a huge baby step, because I think it's a huge baby step, of doing 3 times minimum each week, that's progress, and that is progress that I'm very proud of myself for. There was a week or two where I was probably able to get 4 times a week, even though it was like half an hour of a workout, but a workout is a workout, and you know, you should be proud of yourself for that commitment and that dedication, and that's how I feel about myself. Another thing about my workout today is I have always been hesitant of using the hip thrust machine just because, you know, it was a workout machine that I wasn't really familiar with. But today, I don't know where the braveness came from, but I was finally able to use it. I figured it out on my own, maybe read the little directions just for some guidance, and I got it down and I had a really good workout. Let me tell you guys how good it was. I'm starting to feel sore. So that is definitely good news. But another thing to keep in mind is that when you're working out, in some workouts, you may feel soreness after. Some other workouts, you may not. It just depends on your body. But you don't necessarily have to feel soreness in every single workout to be able to tell that it was an effective workout. And that is a discipline that I'm still learning, because sometimes I would tell myself like, great, I didn't have a good workout. But in reality, I did. And I'm proud of myself, and I should be proud of myself, because why would I spend time being upset about it? I got a good workout, okay? For this vlog, we are going to get ready to go out. You know what I mean? Anyways, you guys already know I had to do my dancey dance. I am gonna go out tonight with some friends, and I'm super excited because I love to dance. I love to dance. It's my most favorite thing in the whole wide world. And tonight I'm gonna be, you know, a safe driver, because I'm driving tonight for the first time when I go out. I've always been the one to get a ride and get picked up from locations, but tonight I have to drive because tomorrow I have to go back to work early in the morning. But next time when I grow out, probably I won't drive. Just go out and be yourself and have fun. And that's what I'm gonna do tonight. And I've done it in the past, but tonight, I don't know. I just feel good about it, because I am going to go to a location I've never been to before. It's gonna be in Scottsdale, and I've never partied out there. But, you know, it might be a good time, and I trust my friends, and I'm very excited to spend the night with them, you know, just living it up. So, we're gonna get ready in this vlog. I'm gonna do my hair, I'm gonna do my makeup, and I'm gonna get pretty. I'm back again. Okay, so I just got out of the shower, and my hair looks like this. It's super damp, but that's the reason why blow dryers exist. The plan I'm gonna do is first I'm going to comb out my hair, and then I'm gonna put on some product, maybe blow dry a little bit, and then put on some oil. Because I'm planning on straightening my hair tonight. And then once I am done blow drying it, I could straighten it, and then I could put the oil on. So let's get started. Yeah. So I just finished blow drying my hair and this is what it looks like. Super poofy, but that's okay. I could honestly continue blow drying it, but since I only have an hour left to do my makeup, my hair, and find an outfit and head over to the location, I need to get started on my makeup. So let's get to the next fun part. All right, so for this part of the vlog, you guys aren't gonna be able to see me because I wanna show you the products that I'm going to use. So in both of these bags, I have my makeup, okay? The first thing I'm gonna show you guys is this palette that I got for Christmas. You guys have already seen it, but I'm gonna show it again. These are the colors, like, come on, like they look so cute. So these next products that I'm showing you guys are for my face. The first thing that I have is my foundation that I love to use. This is a primer that I use. I like to get them in the same brand just cause you know, the ingredients and such. This is, in case I make a mistake and I had to take it off, a really great makeup remover. I like to use this, even though it's a little lighter than my actual skin color, it still does the work in getting rid of those darker spots. This is the eyebrow gel that I use. I am gonna purchase a new one just because, you know, this one's getting a little bit old. This is the brush that I use with it. It is super tiny and it is thin and honestly just gives the great shape for my eyebrows. It gives the extreme lash volume that I look for my eyelashes. And this is a little curling eyelash that I use. Whoops. These are going to be the two brushes I'm gonna use for my eyeshadow. This one, I like to apply the eyeshadow color. This one, of course, to blend it. Let's get started along with my beauty blender. This is a primer I like to use from Dior. It's super good, super light. It just, you know, keeps my makeup on very nicely. And then now we're going to just put it throughout my face, just like that. The next thing I'm going to apply is my concealer. And I'm basically going to apply it a little bit, kind of like a triangle on my eye. And I do sometimes put plenty of it just because as you guys can see the darkness of my under eye. So put it in. And I'm just gonna leave it like that as I do my eyeshadow. Okay, now time for the fun part. So despite whatever shirt I'm going to wear, I know I'm gonna wear dark jeans and black heels. I wanna do a brown tonight. I'm just simply going to do it. So I think the way I've seen it is I first apply the lighter color on the outside and then I do the darker in the eyelid. Let me give it a try. This is what it looks like and I don't know how to feel about it because it is a little dark, but I feel like once I continue to finish blending out my concealer, I put on my foundation and I do my eyebrows, it might look a little better, and especially with the eyelashes, because the eyelashes will cover it a little bit. So I'm gonna trust myself with it, even though it's the first time I wear dark colors like this, but you know, it's gonna be dark anyway. So let's get going. Okay, so this is what my makeup looks like. I am hesitating to put on some eyelashes just because number one, I'm gonna be wearing my glasses. Number two, I'm gonna be dancing a lot, so I'm gonna be sweating. And number three, I'm hoping that maybe I could just put on the mascara again and make it a little darker, a little like higher and stuff, curlier. But I'm gonna straighten my hair and see if it makes it look good. Then just bear with me, let's do it. So this is my hair straightened and good thing I didn't put on the eyelashes because honestly, I think I look very cute. So this is what I'm gonna go with. And now it is time to choose the outfit. I've already mentioned that I was going to do some black heels and dark bottoms. And now I just need to look for a shirt that's gonna match my eyeshadow. So let's go out.